Hello YouTube and welcome back. This is part two of the video about the carnivorous plants. and this is gonna be the fun part because I'm just gonna show you my plants. Part one was about the setup, the shelf, the sensors, how I control the humidifier, those graphs that I can get thanks to the Raspberry Pi and the sensors. I just forgot to mention two things. Actually, the first one I wanted to show you, the ice packs that I am using to cool the temperature at night mostly. I'm gonna use that in the summer during the day if I need to, but mostly it's at night. And the second thing, the Raspberry Pi also sends me an email when one of the safety feature triggers, like if it's really too warm, it's gonna turn off half of the light, and in that case it's also sending me an email, which is cool because I will know it anywhere. I will receive the email on my phone. I'm gonna flip the camera now.
So this is the ice pack I am using from Canadian Tire. Quite cheap, I believe. I have six of them. I just place them in the shelves. You know, wherever I can. Here, I try to put them in the water because it's much more efficient if they touch the water and cool down the water. And I also spray the plants with this thing, and that's out of the fridge, so it's cool water, cool distilled water. And I just sprayed my plant right now, so that it's a little bit. It looks a little bit better on the video. So let's start with the bottom shelf, which is the mini greenhouse, the tropical lowland setup. So what do we have in here? We have two Nepenthes ampullaria. One is a lime twist, so it's this one. I'm gonna show you a picture. Here you go, lime twist, very nice, from CZ Plant. And the other one is from California Carnivores. It is Williams Red cross Harlequin. So I have a nice big picture here. This one is a nice one, and I just got a new one this morning. Let me show you. So this one was open this morning, and after I sprayed the greenhouse with some water, it opened. So it's open for a few hours now. Very colorful already, so I'm happy because I wasn't sure the light was enough on this mini greenhouse. I also have a Nepenthes Albo Marginata Red. This one actually roots got broken during the shipment, I believe, but it's recovering. The bigger leaf, this one, was very small, small like this one, actually the small one. So it's growing, not picturing yet, but growing. What else? Just one more thing in that shelf. Oh, I have another picture for the lime twist, that's cute too here. Not quite the full adult picture shape yet, but it's nice anyways. I like the green peristome. And these are seeds of Nepenthes bicalcarata. So I have plenty of seeds of Nepenthes bicalcarata from two different growers. None of the seeds germinated yet here. Funny thing is that I also put a pot with the same seeds from the same source, two sources, on my intermediate shelf, and three of them germinated on the intermediate shelf. So, but it's much higher, temperature is much higher here, and it's much more humid. But for some reason, the other shelf, they germinated on the other shelf. So I'm still gonna wait. So this is for the lowland. Nepenthes. Okay, that's the subtropical shelf. Okay, what do I have on that shelf? A lot of Droseras that I like or that I wanted to try. So the first one here is Drosera filiformis Florida Red from the ICPS seed bank. Very nice, still seedlings, but I'm not sure if they will reach the light when they get bigger. It's not actually that high, you know, it's like I can almost touch the pot and the lights with my fingers, so it's maybe 20, 25 centimeters, and I don't know. Very nice. I actually saw the seed on only half the surface of the pot. I had some Drosera Birmanis sowed here, but for some reason it did not grow, and I tried two times from the same source, so I think the seeds were not good. Those are my spatulata. I don't really care about those guys. I let them grow and they look so nice. That's the oldest pot I have. I have those guys for a long time now. I bought them from a private vendor in Toronto. And I have some nidiformis, but I let them flower and then although I fed them, they want to die, basically. And then I have a flytrap, standard flytrap, the original, you know, the one you will buy in the local store. It was so small when I bought it in a local store here. And after last winter, so it's the second year I'm growing this plant, and it's all the same plant. I just separated the different grow points after dormancy in February or January. And I planted it in this nice round pot, and it's doing so well. It's loving the IKEA LED light, probably because they are very close to the light, I guess. So it's really nice. I have another flytrap from California Carnivore. So this is the cultivar Ginormous, and traps are so big. It's like more than twice the size of the standard one. And fun fact, I noticed that when the traps are facing the light, they turn so red. It's like so nice. So yeah, very, very nice plant. I guess it just needs a little bit more space here to grow, because that's a little bit too tight here. I have other plants here that I gathered for friends. They come from the other pots. I have too many of them. This is my Drosera madagascariensis, and as you can see, they grow at the same place Drosera birmani grows, the pink one, pink-red one. And madagascariensis probably needs much more light than any other Drosera, because it doesn't really turn red. It produces just a little bit of glue. So yeah, I'm not sure why, but it's growing. It just doesn't produce too much glue and doesn't really turn red. What else do I have? Some baby flytraps, that's also for a friend. This is Drosera caecilifolia, out of tissue culture from CZ Plants. At least it's supposed to be caecilifolia. Now, is it a Birmani? Not sure. Flowers are kind of white, so it could be a Birmani, but the structure, the shape of the flower looks like caecilifolia from what I've been told, so it might well be an actual caecilifolia. It doesn't matter, I like it anyways. I have a clump of them here. It's kind of funny, I don't know what I'm gonna do with that, but I could not separate that from the tissue culture. It was way too small. I'll have to split it at some point, I guess. Nepenthes forest, common, but always very nice, especially when there are so many of them. I also grow some Biblis now, so that's quite new for me. Over 8 seeds, I only got 2 seeds that germinated. There is a small one at the back. I don't know if you can see. At the back there is a small one, but it looks kind of dry. Looks kind of dry, unfortunately. I think the tray was out of water for a day, and the seedling probably needed more water. Those pots are actually quite high, so no water in the tray probably means that the whole pot is quite dry. However, the bigger one is now flowering, so that's a very good news. Let me show you the flower. Here you go. So I'm quite happy with that. Last one on that shelf, Drosera Burmani. Definitely one of my favorites. Too bad this phone cannot focus very closely, because this is really nice. I love it. Pink when you don't feed them. And if you feed them, they become kind of greenish, brownish. So the color change in like a day or so. And when they are hungry, like now, they are very red. So that's for the subtropical shelf. Let's move on to the next one. So this shelf is a little bit of everything, actually. I call it my tropical intermediate because I grow some hybrids but yeah, I grow a little bit of everything. I have my Mexican Pinguicula. I even have Nepenthes, Highland Nepenthes, Glabrata, Macrophylla. I have seedlings of flytrap, so it's a little bit of everything. The shelf has like 80% of humidity, and right now it's a little bit hot. It's 28, so it's a bit hot for Highland Nepenthes, but it's okay for the other ones. I'm gonna start with this one. I have a high expectation for this one. This is a Spectabilis cross veici from CZ Plants, and I really like the first picture that opened. This plant didn't grow for a month after I potted it, and then it started to grow very well with like brown red leaves and new pitcher. So that one is the first one, but I have a smaller one here you can see growing in the moss, and then another one also growing in the moss here, right? So yeah, very, very nice plant. It has those stripes on the peristome. So I should like it. I will like it when it grows bigger, I'm sure. This one is Sibuyensis cross Talagensis. And I'm so sorry if I don't pronounce it properly. I'm just gonna pretend that's the way we pronounce in French, although it's probably not the case. A small pitcher here in the moss, another very small one here, and that's the bigger one I got from that plant. It's not really big, but it's very colorful. I really like it. And there is a new one in between I'm gonna try to show you. Yeah, this guy is very nice, very colorful. So this plant is doing well. It's not turning red, it's just pale, right? It wasn't that pale when I received it. I guess it didn't receive the same amount of light. So it's a very light green, and it has those dark spots, which I believe are nectar glands or something like that. So I believe it's totally normal. And yeah, and the moss is growing so well in those two pots. That's really nice. Then my Macrophylla, so that's from Wistuba. I have two clones of Macrophylla. I'm growing the other one on the bottom shelf. And I decided to grow this one on that shelf more as an experiment than anything else. If it doesn't grow well, I'm gonna move it to the bottom shelf that's cooler. But I have a new picture here on the left. So not colorful yet, but it's growing. Burbidgeae, or Burbidgeae, I don't know. From Wistuba also. So This one is growing well. I also got one new pitcher. And I have some Nepenthes glabratas. Those ones are from tissue culture, from CZ plants. Pitchers were so tiny, now I can see plenty of them. They are much bigger than they used to be, but still they are very small plants. And then my Pinguiculas, this is Agnata cross Gypsy Cola. It catches insects. This is another hybrid, but this one is from California Carnivore. It is Emarginata cross Jomavensis. It is very cute and it's turning pink a little bit. Could be more pink, I think. And this is Pinguicula esseriana, also very cute. That's also from CZ plants with a small, leaf cutting on the side here. Okay, the rest on the shelf are seedlings or seeds. Those are my fly trap seeds, seedlings. Two different containers because two different substrates, peat and sand, and chopped sphagnum moss. I got the same rate of germination on both, so it doesn't seem to matter, at least not for the germination. Now here I have Nepenthes seeds, but nothing germinated yet. This is Reinwardtiana, the red type, and Nepenthes tenuis. Tenuis, I only have 8 or 10 seeds, but nothing germinated, so let's move on. I have my other Bicalcarata seeds in those two containers, and the few ones that germinated are in that container. I don't know if you will be able to see it. Let me try to focus on it. Yeah, here you go. Maybe I can even get closer. Here you go, that's one. There is another one on the side here, actually two others here, so I think I only have three of those. And I feel like they are in the same stage, like for a month or so. They did not grow further. I'm just being patient and I will see. And that's it for the intermediate shelf. Let's move on to the next one, the last one. This one probably contains my favorite species, although they probably need to grow bigger to really be impressive. I still have some tuber droseras that are going into dormancy, so I'm not really gonna go over those, except maybe this one. This is Drosera auriculata. I really, really like Drosera auriculata, and I got such good shots from those leaves earlier this year, and now it's going into dormancy. Other than that, I have here my Drosera regia from CZ plant. It only got a few leaves when I got it, so it is growing. There are new growth, two new leaves, so it's doing good. I love this plant for some reason. It's doing this, the leaves are twisting like that when it catches something. It's really nice. My pygmy sundews. This is Allantostigma. Okay, I think I can get maybe a little bit closer. Go. And this is the Drosera callistos Brankton. And I also have Scorpioides. That's Scorpioides in the middle. Okay, so that's my pink bisandus. Now here I have an Heliamphora, Heliamphora minor, out of tissue culture, and it's doing those adult shape leaf specific to Heliamphora. When I got it from the tissue culture, I mean in the flask, all the leaves, they looked like Sarracenia leaves, you know, those small ones here, but now it's creating those wider ones. And I have four small Nepenthes. Those two are from Brad. So this one is Lingulata, Nepenthes Lingulata. I really like it. It's very small, It doesn't turn red. It's a pale green. The leads are quite the leads are closed. Like, it's very hard to feed them artificially, right? So that was Lingulata from Brad. Now I have also Nepenthes nigra, probably my favorite right now. I have a new picture here on the front, and the leaves turn red. So I'm happy because it means it likes the light. So that's Nepenthes nigra, also from Brad. And in for how long do I have this one? I put it in mid-April. So for in 2 months, I got two pitchers, almost three pitchers in 2 months. So I think that's quite good. Now this one is Nepenthes edwardsiana. I'm very happy with this plant. However, it is very small, very difficult to film with this phone. It's been a month I have it, and it created this new leaf. So it is growing, no problem with it. Let's see if it supports the summer, because the summer is going to be quite warm here. And then Macrophylla, so that's the last one here on that shelf. And Nepenthes macrophylla is the second clone I have. It's also from Wistuba, and it created that new picture at the back. It didn't get any color yet, but it's a new picture that grew in my care, so I'm quite happy. And I think that's pretty much it. Now you have now you know what I grow. You have an overview of my plants, and I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know if you have any question. Post a comment. Thank you.